Good day, everyone. I am Sir Jerickson Chua, and welcome to Animation 1.
Line is a basic symbol used in drawing. Lines make the drawing look more interesting. Texture, movement, light, and space can be described by the quality of line. The types of line he or she uses in drawing will determine the mood and feeling of the subject. The quality of the line could be thick or thin, rough or smooth, and feathery or jagged. For today's lesson, we're going to discuss producing cleanup and in-between drawings. Our learning objectives are as follows. At the end of the lesson, you should be able to observe the principles of line quality in producing cleanup drawing, follow the procedures in cartoon drawing construction, observe drawing proportions, follow procedures for character posing, apply the concept of in-between based on specification, apply concepts views in character designing, and apply the techniques in refining line quality. For our quote of the day, quality is not an act, it is a habit. This is according to Aristotle. So as future animators, we should create quality cartoons and quality drawings as we may venture later on into the animation industry. So our key terms are as follows. We have line quality, line art, model sheet, cartoon drawing, cartoon construction, character proportions, record skipping, character posing, line of action, and character designing. So let's proceed to the principles of line quality. So as we say, line is a basic symbol used in drawing, and it makes the drawing looks more interesting, and it is used to determine really the mood and feeling of our subject. So as you can see here, we have the rough drawing and we have your cleanup drawing, and comparing between the two, okay, between the rough and the cleanup, okay, the line quality of our cartoon or character is much clearer compared to the rough drawing. So here are the uses of line art. So the first one, it is used to define the borders or edges of the drawing, and the contour lines are the most common lines in drawing. So it defines the different borders and edges of your particular drawing, and it presents the outline basically of the cartoon. Okay, number two, it is used to divide the space area of the design, and also it is used as a decoration in drawing. Objects are decorated with linear shapes and patterns. The example on this one, as you can see here, it shows multiple line drawings closer together to produce shades of the object. So shading is one of the key here. These lines are called shade objects. And they are called hatch lines or cross hatch lines. So it uses hatch lines here and here to create the shadow of that particular drawing. Okay, hatch lines are lines going in one direction, while cross hatch lines uses that cross on two or more directions. Okay, so this is an example of hatch line going in one direction, and this one uses cross hatch line. So we have lines going here and lines going here. Line quality is very important in cleaning up because it tells about the appearance of the line. Every production is different and will have different requirements for the type of line drawn by the cleanup artists. Examples of the different production requirements for line quality includes, the first one, we have a sketchy line that suits photocopying on cell. Okay. Next, we have one clean straight line. And we also have thick bold lines for outline and thinner lines for the character. So here are some production requirements in creating line art drawings. Aside from that, we also have each line moving from thin to thick and to thin again, and replacing the line produced by the brush and ink. As you can see here, it follows this rule where it uses thicker lines and thin lines to create a drawing. Okay, so thicker lines of the body parts is closer to the camera. So if you want to create objects that is more closer to the camera, you need to place thicker lines, okay, on that particular object. Okay, so let's proceed now to the principles of line quality. Okay, so the thing about line quality is we have to create a cleaner version of our outline, and we have to create a cleanup version of that particular character, object, or even the background of our animation later on. So here are the principles of line quality that we need to consider. Okay, the first one, lines must be clean, simple, and consistent. Using a nice smooth line will avoid crawling or popping against the surrounding drawings. Okay, number two, in most cases, use a 0.3 lead pencil. If the line is too light, use B. And if the line is too heavy or hairy, use an H. Okay, but primarily, we will be using your 2B pencil as our drawing material. Okay, number three, lazy lines often seen in tracing will make a constructed drawing seem flat. Use both top and bottom light to help avoid them. Okay, next, we also have, we need to connect all lines, especially if we want to check over the drawing for gaps. Okay, five, use straight lines for tension, strength, and hard areas like knees and elbows. Use curved lines for flowy, saggy, and soft areas. Number six is we need to also use varied lines, because if you have mastered a consistent line, then you try to slightly darken your lines on objects that are closest to the viewer to bring them forward. So those are the principles of line quality that we need to consider when drawing our background, our objects, and our characters. So let's proceed now on creating a model sheet. So in the previous chapter, the person can find respective character in different poses like side, back, front, and 3/4. Animating any character without a model sheet will produce major animation problems like inconsistency of character. Even an experienced animator will find it hard to conceive how a character looks like. Okay? So here are the things that we need to consider in creating a model sheet. Number one, we need to prepare all drawing materials that are needed. Okay, so we need to place it in our animation desk or our workstation. Next, we need to draw a character from an angle and sketch out the outline for the character in the exact same way that it should be finished in animation. So basically, we need first to create outline of our character. Just like this one, it uses several lines and it also uses some shapes. So shapes such as oval, okay? We may also place here some arc shape and so on. So outlines and shapes. Next, we need to draw the same character from two more angles in different perspectives. So just like this one, okay, we should create some different angles, okay? We can create the side view, the front view, okay, and 3/4 view, and so on. Next, number four, we need to draw the head or face of the character in different moods. The four basic moods is the happy, angry, sad, and fearful. And number five, we also have to draw the possible poses of the action of the character. And we also need to follow the steps 2 to 5 from every other character in the animation. Because one of the reason why we do that is to make sure that our drawing will be of quality and it is consistent. Okay? Model sheet must be used for all the main characters in animation to avoid repeating steps 2 to 5. Okay? So those are the things that we need to consider in creating a model sheet. Now, let's proceed how to follow the procedures in cartoon drawing construction. Okay, so the process of learning how to draw is made easier when subjects are first drawn as assemblies that are made of simple geometrical shapes. Okay, so just like this one, it follows simple geometrical shapes such as we have the circle, we have a rectangle here, rectangle there, okay, and other shapes that are necessary to draw the outline of our character. Okay, so everything around can be described with geometrical shapes. Objects can come in the form of cubes, okay, blocks, cylinders, spheres, and among others, okay, that you can use primarily in creating your cartoon drawing. Flat surfaces on a subject may be made of flat geometrical shapes like squares, triangles, rectangles, rhombuses, okay, trapezoids, ovals, and others. So learning how to draw using geometrical shapes is one way to help animations or animators draw what they C. Okay? So that's how we do cartoon drawing construction. Now, how do we do the making of the basic shapes in order for us to create your character? Okay? So in animation, basic shapes play a very important role in constructing a character and props accurately. Shapes are used to relay a message. It is easier to build a character if shapes are used and organized. So everything around us is composed of many shapes. These basic shapes will give visual cues to describe a character. They become the basis for the overall traits and attitudes of character. And any drawing can easily be constructed by using one or more combination of shapes like in the example here. Okay? So as you can see here, it follows different basic shapes. And each of that shape represents how the character will have its behavior and how it presents itself. Okay? So just like this one, okay, if we use several triangle shapes, okay, we can create women like character, okay? If we want to create built character, we can use rectangles, okay? If we use tall characters, we can use cylinders to create the basic shape and so on, okay? So each of these shape represents what the character you want to create. So let's proceed now to character construction. So simple cartoon character is made up of three basic shapes. We have the circle, the square, and the triangle. And we need to combine these shapes to create a design of character. So let's start with circles. So when we say circles, these are used to simply create cartoon characters which are cute, cuddly, and friendly types of characters. Women, babies, and fluffy animals usually depend on circular shapes. Just like this one, okay, if you want to create a little cute, this is a bear, I guess this is a bear or a mouse, I don't know. Okay, if you want to create this particular character, you just need to use several circles, okay, to create a cute, cute character. Next, we have squares. So this is used to depict dependable, solid, or heavy characters, just like this one, okay? So strong characters, okay, such as policemen or a dad, okay, and so on. Okay, and we also have here triangles. And triangles are used to represent the bad guys or villains in the character design, just like this one, okay? So those are the common drawing construction shapes that we need to consider in cartoons. Next, in shapes, there are interchangeable, meaning we need to begin by drawing a box, a sphere, and a cylinder until you are comfortable drawing in three dimensions. Okay, keep practicing these shapes until you are already comfortable with it. Try to experiment by stretching, bending, or twisting these shapes in order for us to create our objects, okay? So here are some basic shapes that we need to consider, okay? Just like this one. Once we create the basic shapes, we can now outline our drawing, okay, using this basic shape. And then once we have created the outline, okay, we can now create the cleanup version of these outlines. And as you can see here, it's quite simple, but as a newbie in animation, okay, it needs practice, okay, to really create these kinds of character. So let's now proceed to basic drawing proportions, okay? So proportions of human figure differ from cartoon figure proportions. In constructing a cartoon character, it is important to consider the proportion or the structural features of the character. The proportion of the character varies according to the gender and physique and how cute, heavy, or solid the character is. Oval shape is used to measure the height of our character. So as you can see here, we follow what we call the head tall, okay? Meaning, for example, we have a 10-year-old boy, okay? It follows the 4 1/4 head tall feature, meaning we can create circles here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1/4 to create a 10-year-old. For a 6-year-old, we follow the 4 head tall And for a 3-year-old, it follows the 3-head skull. Okay, so this is the primary measure in order to us to create the character proportions. Okay, so here are the guidelines in creating the character proportions. Okay, so if we have 5 heads tall, we have taller characters. Okay, if we have 4 heads tall, longer body, that suggests maturity, such as this one. Okay, and this one. If we have 3 heads tall, this is childlike proportions. Okay, just like this one. 2 heads tall, we have dwarfs or aliens and small animals. Okay, just like this one. And 1 head tall, only a head. So, you can see this on the different Digimon characters. It only have 1 head. Okay. So, in cartoon character, it is measured by the number of heads. As a general rule, use 5 heads for tall characters, 4 heads for normal characters, and 3 heads for small or childlike characters. Okay, so we need to consider those. Most animation studios use oval shapes to measure the height of a character. For example, we have here the different body proportions of a child and an adult character. So as you can see here, these are the characters in Aladdin. Okay, so you may use the basic shape principles such as this one, okay, to create our characters as this one. Okay, so the most common shape used for cartoon studios to build a character is format in a pear shape, okay, as seen on these principles. Okay, and we need to determine the simple skeleton structure of the character, okay, for us to create a build and create the format of an easier correct proportion of that particular character. Okay, just like this one. Okay. So after a body is formed or defined, determine the simple skeleton, okay, structure of the character. The muscles and bones vary among different cartoon character, and it is important to understand the differences of skeleton structure of any kind of character because this will serve as a guide in constructing the joints such as elbows and knees, okay? So realistic drawings are different from cartoon drawing. In cartoon, the gestures and physical characteristics of a character must convey a message to the audience without having a dialogue or a scene orientation. Realistic drawings are based on what is real or anything existing that can be seen. Being realistic, drawings have 3 dimensions, height, width, and depth. Examples, we have trees, rocks, clouds, air effects, and light. Okay, and in order for us to complete the character with the final details, we need to walk around the different structure of our characters. Okay, so just like this one, okay, we need to create the outline first, the basic shapes, in order for us to create the final drawing. Okay, now based on our previous discussion, how do we record and store the cleanup drawings? Okay, so after cleanup artists work on the scene and finished, this scene folder is forwarded to the cleanup artist assistant, cleanup checker. The cleanup checker examines the scene against the storyboard and the model pack, the exposure sheet, and even the animation roughs. Then the artist signs off the scene folder as approved. The scene is forwarded to the cleanup production assistant for encoding and later on the production department. Okay, so why do we have to do the records keeping? Okay, so when animating, the animator needs to sit down and do the drawing of his or her character by moving around on the different animation paper. In that case, he or she uses the artistic part of the brain, filling out the exposure sheet, and anything but artistic and the functions move to different parts of the animator's brain. This requires a definite brain shift, and in animators in general prefer to use this artistic side and do not like shifting. Okay? The exposure sheet is vital to the animation process in a sense that it passes on the audio soundtrack information to the animator, and the animator sequencing of drawings to the assistant animator and computer animator. It all passes the information concerning the camera positioning from the layout artist to the animator and then to the camera operator. If this information is not recorded properly, the next person in line will not know what to do. If someone handed you a pile of animation drawing and asked you to shoot it at a pencil test without providing an exposure sheet, you might get confused. Okay? So there may be moments when you would have to guess as to what you are supposed to do. So it's very important to keep these records, okay? Especially the exposure sheets. There may be moments when you would have to check even if the animator has to shoot their own pencil test, okay, a week later, because it is possible that the sequencing they originally had in mind might be lost. So let's proceed now to character posing. So character posing is the most important work of an animator. Posing a character includes traits, abilities, and body shapes of the character in different situations and emotions. Every pose must tell something about the character. It should be readable. It must show the character is what is doing, feeling, and how the character responds to different situations. The gestures of the character must convey an action. Okay, so what makes a good pose? So here are the things that we need to check in order for us to create a good pose, okay? So the first one, it should tell a story even without the in-between drawing. So basically, even when you are drawing the rough of that character, it really presents the story itself. Okay, just like this one, okay, if you can deduce that this character is a superhero, okay? So it should also convey the character's emotions, feelings, and actions. It also allows the audience to see what is inside the soul of the character, okay? So as a superhero, it has superpowers, okay? It guides the eyes of audience on the flow lines. It invokes simplicity and clarity in one glance. And it should look natural and appealing. And it has a readable silhouette, okay? So these things are to be considered in order for us to create a good pose. So our character animations comprise sequences of poses and expressions. These are creatively applied by the animator on the characters in a scene based on the given turnaround model of the characters. A single pose is a snapshot from a series of poses joined together by a flow of movement towards the object or purpose of that action. Okay, so just let's take one, okay? You can now see the different poses of this particular character, and this is Hercules, okay? Next. So, what is the importance of line of action? Okay, so line of action is basically an indicator of the movement, direction, and energy of the character's pose. It is an imaginary curved line through the body of the character that shows the primary force of a pose. The line of action makes the character pose more visually interesting to the viewer. Line of the action must not be straight or S-shaped, because this will impede the character's pose and make it look rigid and stiff. So as you can see here, the line of action in these presented characters, it uses some arcs. Okay, so just like this one, so they just stroke this and then stroke a line there to create that punching action. Okay, a C shape. Okay, to create a sitting position. Okay, this shape, and this shape. Okay. So, line of action is very important in creating a more exaggerated cartoon action. Okay, so another one that we need to consider in character posing is what we call silhouette. So, one of the most important elements of good pose is a readable silhouette. So, negative space and silhouette must express emotions and must fill every space with details, as it would allow the eye as a restful place. The negative space around the character should be free of content. So these are examples of silhouette, or what we call our shadows in our characters. Next is what we call contrast. So another element of good pose is adding contrast to a character. In art, Contrast is a distinct difference between elements of form or composition either visually or in a subject matter. Creating a character will add appeal to the poses. One way of adding more emotions and attitude to a pose is tilting the head and hips, okay? And this will add weight to the pose. Shoulders, hips, and torso should face in different direction to add more appeal. An even distribution of weight makes it more dynamic and alive. So these are examples of contrasting characters, okay? So let's proceed to the tactics in defining line quality. So lines are the basic elements used in drawing. All forms of visual arts and drawings are based on using lines. Animators use numerous lines to form a single line and creating a rough drawing. Line is used to define the edges of objects. It describes the form and movement and indicates value and light source in drawing. It can represent something that is not even there, and the qualities of the line help describe the appearance of the character. So what are the uses of line? First, it defines the shape. It creates movement and emphasis. It develops pattern and texture. It shades and models using hatching and cross-hatching and stippling. Okay? And it also communicates emotion and tastes or states of mind through its character and direction. So when we say hatching, so we have these lines. Cross hatching is when we create these lines and these lines, and stippling when we create multiple dots in that particular drawing. So that's what we call stippling. Okay, next, there are five types of lines, okay, that we need to consider in our drawings, okay? So we have the vertical, horizontal, diagonal, zigzag, and curved lines. Okay, so for vertical lines, these are representing, okay, the feeling of loftiness and spirituality. So vertical lines, we have here lines that are going upwards or downwards, okay? For horizontal lines, these suggest a feeling of rest or response. For diagonal lines, they suggest a feeling of direction, okay, which is going upward, okay? For example, we have graph, okay, that moves upward, that is a positive response, okay? We have zigzag lines, this expresses uncertainty or anger. And for curved lines, these suggest confusion, turbulence, or even frenzy, as in the violence of waves in a storm, okay? So those are the kinds of line that we can use on refining your line quality. So, how to draw a better line art? So, the following are the techniques taken from How to Draw a Better Line Art by Regent Dreamer to practice or achieve a stroke line. Okay? So, the first one is we need to practice. So, draw large arcing lines on a rough sheet of paper. Once that fill out the page, they do not go anywhere in particular. But this will help loosen up your arm so that you will be able to make those confident strokes. Break out the sketch pad and have fun drawing lines everywhere, okay? Once you practice that, then you need to draw lines slowly. This will improve your technique. You will get more squiggles when you first learn how to do this. But over time, you will get less and less squiggly, okay? Once done, you need to draw lightly first. Drawing lightly will build confidence in your strokes. You may have few lines break when you are sketching. Then go over the lines with slower, more refined single stroke, okay? And the last one, we need to draw with your whole arm instead of your wrists. This will get much broader range of control and can draw much cleaner lines this way. It takes getting used to, but it is the best way to draw, okay? So those are the techniques that we can adapt later on when you will be creating your line art drawings. Okay, so line quality or weighted line. So what's the difference between the two? Okay, so weighted line is more on the heavier side, okay? And in terms of the line quality, okay, it presents the totality of your character or your object, okay? So line quality is the thickness and thinness of a line. When doing a line art, the weight, motion, and depth are determined by the thickness of a line. A thinner line indicates fragility, while a thicker line indicates solidity. Thick lines also feel heavier than thinner lines. Thin lines gives a sense of movement, while thick lines gives the opposite. Okay? Let's proceed to the concepts of character designing. Animation became popular because both young and adults love it. Some people prefer animated movies because they are less stressful to watch. Animated movies are colorful and entertaining. There are some who grew attached to cartoon characters, just like me. That is why even adults spot a character that reminds them of themselves, how they wanted to be, or how they are now, and fall in love with it. When creating a good character, design is such a way that people will love it and can relate to it. It is all important to the way it looks, talks, walks, and thinks that empower the character. Even if a character is good or bad, cute or weird, happy or sad, it must still be lovable or memorable character. There is no scientific formula in character designing. Animators design characters based on the way people relate to them. Characters must be friendly, interesting, and appealing to almost all age groups. So here are the basic principles of character design. There are a few basic principles or guidelines that animators use as a basis for creating a successful character. The first one is what we call function. So character design must follow function wherein a character is logically and the form is easy to understand. Basic shapes like circles or ovals are best used as the wireframe for the character. Simplicity in the character's overall shape is also great to draw from various angles. When rotating or viewing a character from another angle, all planes within the character's design will change their appearance in proportion to the angle, making it harder to maintain consistent proportions and scale for each characteristic. Thus, starting off from a more basic general shape or generic shape requires less effort in accurately representing the character in different positions, just like this one. Next is style or aesthetic. The style or general aesthetic used in designing a character can make or break a character. The style of the character comes from the way in which the shapes that compose it blend together in a visually stimulating manner. Contrast of shape, form, or proportion is a great way to balance shapes and make a character more interesting. Character's eye can be essential in defining their personality. Next is their personality. Okay, so the personality of the character is composed of character's physical traits and its features. Exaggerated features, okay, and elongated heads, big jowls, plump body, prominent bow legs, deep underbite, among others, are examples of personalities that can have a great impact on the totality of your character itself. Okay, so let's proceed on how to design our own character. So the first one, we need to start with an idea, with a character, doodles using shapes. Okay, doodling can be used to create beautiful and interesting design. Okay, so we start from the basic shapes, use different line qualities, okay, use different doodles, okay, and use the different pear shape in order for you to create your basic outline of your character. Okay, once that is done, okay, you need to draw a flat, simple, abstract shape for the head, then add more details like eyes, ears, and other features. Exaggerate the head, but retain the correct proportions of the real head. Okay, next. Number three, we need to establish the facial proportions of the character. Okay, the eyes must be placed above the ears. Okay, just like in our normal face shape, okay, our eyes is above our ear. Okay, as seen on this particular drawing. Okay, next. We need to take photos. Why do we need to do that? Because taking photos of people as a reference material for the style of clothing, hairstyle, and face can have a great impact on our own character. Style of character may be varied if there are many reference materials, but it really depends on your imagination, really, if what character you want to present. Number five, you need to exaggerate the expression of the character by using any part of the face to give life to a character, such as disheveled hair or teeth with gaps between them. Use squares for strong and bold characters, triangles for scary characters, and smooth curves for a friendly character. Then, draw the character's sequence of actions and experiment with movement, such as walking or dancing, to add its personality. So, that's how you can design your own character, okay? As a summary of our discussion for today, okay, we have discussed the following. We have the principles of line quality, how to create a single model sheet, okay, drawing, cartoon drawing, how to do cartoon construction, the character proportions, records keeping, character posing, the line of action, line art, and character designing. And as an end quote for our animation one, the limits of possible can only be defined by going beyond them into the impossible. This is according to Arthur Clarke. So for our PETA 9, which will be our last performance task for this subject, you're going to construct your own character, okay? And you have to make sure that this should be colored and it has a cleanup version, okay? So you also need to apply the 6th tip of line drawing, and you need to create a turnaround model such as this one of your own character.
Thank you for watching, and I hope that you have learned many things from our discussion. Keep safe and God bless.